Hello everyone, I'd like to acknowledge and thank our subscribers who commented in the last video. I really appreciate your support. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button as it helps us make great content for you here on this channel.
Pardon the interruption, guys, but I have a special announcement to make. Three words, Wolf and Gang. What is Wolf and Gang? It's you, it's me, it's this community. It's for us independent filmmakers. Now, we've done something special. We've opened up a web store and we're releasing a one-time limited edition drop titled Forever and Ever. This lineup is made for filmmakers like you and I, the film enthusiast, and for just fans of cinema. If you can tell me what movie inspired this entire lineup, we're gonna give the first person that gets it right in the comments below a free t-shirt. If you wanna support us, head over to wolfandgang.com, pick yourself a hoodie, a hat, a shirt, we got jackets. We appreciate your support. Back over to Phil.
Ladies and gentlemen, and filmmakers of all ages, today I wanna bring up the topic battery life, and more specifically, battery life for the Blackmagic Pocket 4K and 6K. But wait, all of you non-Blackmagic Pocket users out there, don't click off just yet. Yes, it's true, we love Blackmagic design cameras, but it's also true that Blackmagic Pocket 4K and 6K cameras currently have the worst battery life. So if we can find a solution for this issue, then we solve all battery issues in the process. At least that's what we hope to accomplish. And I'm here to tell you that we finally found the solution, and all thanks to the best top handle in the world, the Indie Pro Power Grip. Unfortunately, the Universal Power Grip is not the battery solution that I'm talking about here, but because of this thing kind of failing on me, I'm now able to give an honest review of the product. It might seem like I'm talking crap, but I assure you I'm not. Indie Pro makes a lot of different products for filmmakers, and Indie Pro gave it its best shot, but ultimately I ended up going back to V-mount battery. But could there be a third contender? And I'm not lying when I say that this is the best top handle in the world. It is, at least for my perspective it is, simply because it just does more than any other normal top handle out there. Sure, it's super thick, it takes time to adjust to the odd bulkiness of it all, but if you're looking for a great top handle that provides your camera and monitor with power, you found your man. But as a suitable one-stop shop battery source, especially for the Blackmagic Pocket 4K and 6K, it just falls a little short. What do I mean? Well, when I first bought the Indie Pro Power Grip, I was just trying to build on an already minimalist rig setup that we did a video on earlier this year. You can click the link above to see that video. What we tried to do in that video was not only show minimalist parts, but have minimalist price as well. I felt that when it comes to price point, maybe a bigger battery would allow for a budget stretch. But when you compare the 70 watt hour top handle battery over other V-mount batteries with similar watt hours, then the Indie Pro Power Grip falls short of the minimalist budget category as well, because Indie Pro is just too expensive for the power. You can find 90 watt hour V-mount batteries for about $90, whereas the Indie Pro Grip is 70 watt hours and $269 on Amazon. I'm not saying those cheaper priced batteries are gonna be good, but if you can power your camera for up to 3 hours at a time, then you've already won on your investment. The quality of Indie Pro is great. It feels well built and has many power output options for your accessories, but it starts to become a hassle when you reach low battery. You can't just swap out the battery in an instant. You have to unscrew it and completely take off the top handle and replace it with the new top handle. And most top handles are home to our video monitors as well, so you'd have to take that off and reattach those two. All that hassle ends up turning the best top handle in the world into an overpriced 70 watt hour battery eyesore real quick. I wanted to make this video as unbiased as possible for people who are looking for a real in-depth look at a product from someone who will actually put it through its paces. But if you're like me and you just won't be reasoned with, just know that this top mount battery option is fine for short-term recording. Recording events, hosting YouTube videos, or personal use. This single battery is fine, though it is heavy and bulky. If you ever plan on shooting even a short film or music video, I would pass on this option. The cheapest solution in the long run is to buy V-mount batteries. They're future-proof. But along with the V-mount battery, you will need to make a few one-time purchases. Buy a standard non-electrical V-mount plate. I've seen them for less than $40. Then you'll need a charger. Keep in mind that the IndiePro Power Grip does not have a charger either. You can find one for about 50 bucks, but if you want a reliable charger, you can pick up other V-mount chargers for around 140 bucks that allow you to charge two V-mount batteries at a time. Then finally, you'll need a D-tap cable to plug the battery into your camera. So here we go. The minimalist V-mount battery setup. Battery, $90. Charger, $50. D-tap cable, $25. For a grand total of $165, and since the small rig or tilter cage that you're gonna buy to attach it all to is already $100, you're now at the same price point as the IndiePro top handle battery. And remember, the IndiePro does not come with a charger, so use the extra money to purchase other accessories. But wait, there is a third option here. So many camera manufacturers are adopting the NPF battery system, and we'll do the same. We recently bought a small rig NPF battery adapter plate. This seems to be a great option for three reasons: more affordable batteries, lightweight rig setups, and battery swaps are as easy as traditional V-mount batteries. But if you're gonna be powering your camera with NPF battery power, I wouldn't recommend using anything smaller than a 750. This will give the Blackmagic Pocket users roughly around 1 hour of power. Better than the included LPE6 battery, but still not great. 970 would be your best bet here. The only problem we ran into was when we started adding accessories like monitors and transmitters and follow focus systems. Unless you know exactly what wattage output each of your accessories is giving, it becomes troublesome trying to keep track of how long the NPF battery will actually last you. With larger V-mount power, you're more at ease. The small rig NPF battery adapter does allow you to check the battery life, which is helpful, but the goal here is to eliminate continuous battery swaps. Sometimes you're on a roll and swapping batteries would disrupt that. And how many times has the screen gone black on you right in the middle of a shoot? This video is not about price. It's not about portability. It's not about comfort. It's about battery life. And V-mount batteries just do it for me. The more watt hours, the more possibility. The IndiePro Power Grip top handle is a great concept and design, but it just doesn't work for me and what I do, which is long form commercial work. Spending hours at a time on set and then changing top handles is just too expensive and too time consuming. I could see myself using more of the 970 battery setup over the top handle. I would just have to make a specific build for NPF batteries for quick run and gun shoots. Something not too heavy. I wouldn't want to be out on the field longer than about 6 hours with that setup. But if you plan on making movies, then NPF batteries are not future proof. The V-mount seems to be the better choice for me personally, but you tell me. What are your thoughts on our choice for battery solutions? What are you currently using on your setup? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you like this video, please hit that like button and consider subscribing for more videos and content like this. Just click that notification bell to be notified when new videos drop. And thank you to all of our subscribers for your continued support. We appreciate every single one of you. Until next time, peace.